Please stand by. Hello. Hi, everyone. So today I'm going to be doing some work on some ambiences, which would just be kind of the environmental sounds that play in the background of the game and kind of tell you what type of environment you're in. It's kind of the equivalent of being Bob Ross for audio, and it's fun. It seems kind of simple, but sometimes it can get pretty tricky, especially for games. It's not usually the case that you just make a minute-long file and just load that in, and that's what plays. Usually, especially in the case of our game, where we have time of day and things like that, you kind of need to break things out into separate layers. So, like, you'd break out just crickets, and then you'd have a cricket loop, or maybe even individual cricket chirps that would then get triggered by the game. But then, of course, when it's daytime, you need to turn that down. I have a few different kind of biomes that I'm working on right now. Two different types of forests, some kind of near the ocean sounds, but not beachy sounds. Some swampy stuff, and then another aspect of it is that we want to sell with audio what realm owns the particular region that you're in as well. So there will be visual cues that let you know, oh, you know, the Vikings own this plot of land that I'm walking through right now. But we also, of course, want there to be some audio there as well to help cue you into that. Fart noises are my water jug opening. It really makes me happy. Okay. So, I've already started this session a little bit, so I'll just kind of play like some of the things of what I've previously done, just so you can kind of see like what's happening. Yep, crickets. And here's another one. A little more isolated. Similar, but different perspective slightly. And then we have another set of crickets from a different type of forest. Very peaceful, right? So that's like a good track to start with. I'll just make a short little cricket loop out of this one. There are some things that I might not necessarily want in this. So there's a little bit of wind in there. Which might be okay. See if I can find a spot that has less wind. Probably here a bit. No? Let me zoom in on my waveform a little bit. Sometimes that helps. I'm still probably going to take this part right here. There's like a twig breaking in there. Yep. I'll go before that. Let me get off gridlock there. Okay, so that's 6.7 seconds of audio. I'm just going to pop it over to the front here just so I can do some editing of it. And So right away, I can take out some of the low end, and that will get rid of some of that slight roar that you hear. It's not a roar, but it's a low mid frequency rumble. I'll preview that. This makes it, I'm previewing it and it just collapsed down to mono, but that won't be the case when I actually process it. So see how like the wind noise is pretty much gone, but the crickets are still there because they're all high frequency sounds. Maybe roll out, see how make it slightly duller because it's almost piercing. Yeah, I don't mind. Well, probably what's going to happen is I will compress this file, not with the audio compressor, but with data compression, and I can drop the sample rate. So this high end will probably get cut off anyways. This bit that I'm doing right here, I'm just filtering off the very most top end. It's probably going to get cut off due to the data compression anyways, because I'll probably drop it down to a lower sample rate. But, yeah, I'll just stick with that for now. So I rendered that, which means this file now sounds like that. And now we got to make it loop. And since it's rhythmic, you kind of have to pay attention to that. Otherwise it'll like sound like the frogs have a weird hiccup or something. So you can kind of see these three. I'm looking at this top part here. See those three little blip, blip, blip? And there's three right there. So I'm going to do cut right before the first one and then load this back on top of these other three blips. There's these other three right there. And I'll do like that. Apply a little crossfade. I'll probably slide that over a little bit. And then let's just see where that gets me. It's kind of noticeable because there's a little speed up there between these three guys. It is a short loop, which is not really ideal. Like I'd probably go for like a 10-second loop, ideally. Let's just slide that over to this part. I kind of hear it, and I don't really want to make it shorter, but that might be the only way to make it sound a little more in time with itself, because they are rhythmic. I think you can actually even like determine what temperature it is by how frequently they make their sounds, at least for some species anyways. So yeah, it's just this one thing. It's like every little, he sped up, I guess, kind of naturally, but that's making it sound like not a good loop. That one feels a little better, even though it's shorter. So another trick you do, like even though this is a short file and you can kind of hear the loop, like something you might do is you would, like in the game, you would have, go up there. You might have like a couple of them playing, and that would kind of help offset. When you have two like that, it becomes a lot harder to pick out the loop. It wouldn't just be two of the exact same length, actually. It would be like something like this. So that way there is no easy sync point. You do like that in game. So like even though it's still part of the same file, on one version of it, I've just chopped off the end. So when there's two, they don't, I mean, you can see just where the cuts are, that they don't line up. It'll take, you know, many, many loops for them to line back up to the where they were the first time. So that's a very simple example. I'm going to get on with it. Let's get this guy out of here. Let me name him or her. Let's see. Ambient Pine Forest Cricket Few Loop. Okay, I'm going to copy that. Just so I can kind of keep my naming conventions similar. I mean, what's going on here? Looks like there's a little sliver of something else. Oops. Is this the whole thing? Yeah. Okay, Ambient Pine Forest Cricket Few Loop is pretty much still few. I'll just do 03. And then I export this out into another file. So that's that. That was a very, very simple example. Also, I did not really have to do anything from this one because it was so pristinely recorded. This guy, Gordon Hempton, is his name, and he runs a company called Quiet Planet, and he's been recording like nature stuff for 30 years. And it's really, really amazing. That's one of my favorites. Let me see. I'll try and link him in chat, actually. Yeah. So that's him. He's on like kind of a campaign to help nature. By reducing our noise pollution, because that can be kind of a serious issue for certain animals. Like, I mean, he focuses on land-based stuff, but it's definitely the case with ocean stuff too, because we have all these shipping lanes of, you know, massive ships going, and that like interferes with the calls of whales, and they can't find each other. So, kind of interesting to think about. Or noise pollution affecting things like that. It's really hard to record just absolutely pristine ambiences too. Like if you've ever done it, you go out and you're like, oh, this sounds great. I can hear all this stuff and I hear the birds and the wind. And then you put on the headphones and you turn up the volume. And you're like, oh, there's like an AC generator going somewhere that you didn't know you were near. And or you can hear like planes off in the distance, or there's a highway that you can't really hear with your ears, but once you put on the headphones, you hear it. So anyways, it's not an easy task. It takes a lot of time to like find an actual location that doesn't have human noise pollution. These are ones I exported out earlier. So those are just individual, like, bird chirps. I mean, it gets pretty granular. So then in the game, those would all get kind of randomly played back. The cool thing about that is then if it's raining, I'm getting pinged. That's all right. If it's raining, I can turn down the birds, because sometimes birds don't really talk much when it's raining, so I could still have like other nature sounds happening, but specifically turn down the birds. Let's see. Oops. So that's a nice cricket one. Let's see if I can do something a little different with this one. It's really quiet. Oops, I keep clicking in the wrong spot. So I'm going to normalize it, which is it just looks for the highest peak in the file and sets it to a certain volume. And it's probably going to bring up the noise floor a whole lot. See how much rumble there is in that? There's a lot of rumble in that, so... Boy, I'm not clicking in the right spot there. So let's go ahead and take out some of the rumble. Check something real quick. My addition path should be stereo. That's weird. Oh, maybe I had it set. No? Huh. I don't know why it's not stereo. Anyways. It's like, what can I get away with, right? There's a lot of white noise back there. Especially compared to those other ones that I listened to. And I just heard a dog, too. That's probably pretty good. Fix it. Yeah, there's still a fair amount of white noise in there. I'll take that to start. So, if there's particular elements, I don't really like that buzzing. And that guy's pretty much throughout the whole track. Yeah, it might not be too bad, but... Okay, so I am going to... I usually just kind of copy and paste my iterations here. Just in case I want to go back, because I'm about to do something to this next part. Via noise reduction. These are just like the magical Photoshop plugins of audio. I don't really even understand how they work. But I'll show you another example in a little bit too of some really cool stuff, but... This is, you can set it to adaptive, which means it's just kind of like determining on its own what the noise profile of this particular audio clip is, which is going to be itself, because normally what you would do is you'd be like, you know, you'd have a track that has dialogue in it, and then in between the dialogue, you'd hear the background noise, right? And you'd say, oh, okay, you'd set this thing to manual, you'd highlight the noise, and you'd say learn. And then it'd be like, oh, okay, that's what the noise profile is. And then you'd select the whole track that had the dialogue in it. And then you'd say, well, remove all of the noise from the rest of this track. And it will go through and, like, leave you with just dialogue. And it's pretty amazing how it works. I'm almost abusing it right now, but I'm just gonna see what it does. Okay, so then you can get in here and you can start telling what particular frequencies you don't want. So this 2K is that zzz guy, right at 2000 hertz. And I forget which way you do it. Okay. There's a bit of a resonance there. That's actually, maybe that's not him. Oh, you know what? Yeah, he's up there at 10K. Silly me, I don't know my frequencies well, I guess. So the question is, do I even want this? It's kind of... You know, like, I don't know if that really sounds that great. Like, let's just bypass it. There's a nice echo to some of those crickets that I like. That guy. Now he's gone. And he'll come back. There he is. But it just like reduces, it kills the reverb of everything. So I'm going to put that on hold for a second and go to another plugin. Spectral Repair. Oh yeah, I can only do 45 seconds of this. So let's see, what is 45 seconds? Holy crap, that's a long file. That's 37 seconds. It's a really long file. I had no idea it was that long. So yeah, let's just do 35. That's fine for my purposes. Load it in. This is frequency over time. This is like one of the coolest things ever. If you're an audio nerd like me, but you can literally see like individual cricket chirps in this thing. And it's like I was saying before, it's like the Photoshop of audio programs. So you can go in, you can try and like highlight individual sounds that you want and try and discard the things you don't want. So that's weird. Look, there's like a weird cut in the high frequencies up there. That's weird. I don't know what that is. It's almost like a digital artifact. Anyway, you see weird stuff with these programs. I think Aphex Twin like loaded a picture of himself in one of these programs and then like printed it out and used that audio in one of his songs or something like that. You can do the opposite. You can make a sound from a picture if you want. So I'm going to, so I just selected like all this high frequency stuff and I'm going to reduce it. Yeah, so see how, like, that's where all that buzzing is? I just undid what I did. I'll redo it. Now it's gone. It's kind of dull sounding now, but maybe that's okay. I don't actually know if I'm going to get what I want out of this. What I'm eventually going to try for is just, let's see if we can just leave these little guys in here. But I don't know if that's going to work. Sometimes it gets to, you end up creating too many artifacts. Even just right now on the high end, it sounds real like, it almost sounds like a bad, like, digital or like electronic interference, you know, like if your audio cables are too close to like a power transformer or something, it kind of sounds like that on the high end right now. So maybe I'll undo that and back down on the strength. I don't know how to, I'm not a master of this program. It's actually a very deep program. Oops, sorry, that was my mic stand. See if that, yeah, so I reduced the bands. Maybe I need more bands. More bands? I don't know. Weird. Let's try fewer bands. Yeah. Maybe I need more bands, but like way stronger. Yeah, it's basically just doing an EQ at that point. Because really, I could have just done that with an EQ, basically, once I loaded it in here and saw where the problem frequencies were. But it's okay. I'm going to slide this down. And let's see what I can do with these guys. Probably don't need to be so aggressive there. Let's just see what it does. There is this like peak around 2K, which is interesting. You can kind of see this band here. I guess I should explain that the brighter it is, the more volume there is of that frequency at that time. So probably fairly obvious, but just thought I'd explain that. So you can see there's like this weird little band in here that might have actually be a result of the EQ that I did earlier, because sometimes that'll happen. I'm going to try and cut that out. I might as well just do the whole bottom end too, because I don't really care about that. Oh, weird. Oh, so it like... I think I've... Huh. That made a weird kind of artifact down here. See how there's like... It like mirrored the lower cricket chirps down through the lower frequency stuff when they're not there, right there. So I think it has to do with the surrounding region length. No, that's okay. Because it'll kind of, it's probably just because my, it's, yeah, that's what it is. Yeah, because I had it right there, and it was, so see these dotted lines expanding and contracting around the main bar? It kind of looks at those other frequency areas and says, oh, this is, I need to like kind of gradually fade into this. But really, since I'm, it's just under what I actually want to keep. I want that as tight as possible. It's still doing it. I don't know if I can get much closer without... Maybe. I don't care about those guys. Maybe I'll just go with these guys. I'm still too close. I need to back off. You can tell it did it in the middle too still. Maybe I'll go back one more. Yeah. So those, that's weird. That must be some other creature in the background there.
I mean, there's this part right here. I don't know what that is. Let's do that and see what I can get away with there. I wonder what this is going to sound like. Yeah, doesn't sound real good. Like I said, I wasn't sure if I was going to actually be able to accomplish what I wanted here. I'm just trying something here. Yeah, it's still creating those artifacts. That's weird. Whoops. Not what I meant to select. Yeah, it's still doing it. That just sounds terrible. I'm gonna cancel this. Don't like it. Not doing what I wanted to do. But it's still kind of a cool foray into that program. Well, let's try what my initial thought was, or revelation was in that other part, which was just that buzziness is just on the top end. There's still like a weird peaky part in the middle that I'm not very happy with. I got rid of the buzzy though. The buzzy guy. I could try something weird here. I don't know if it's gonna work. I could try and look for a spot that doesn't have any cricket. Nope, that did. I think it's all going to. That almost works. Okay, there's one more. Yeah, he comes in at the end there. There's still cricket in there, but I'm just going to try something. Let's do the noise reduction thing that I was working on earlier. Do the learn. Tell it to listen to that weird little snip that I just pulled out. And then now we're actually doing noise reduction. And it's supposed to be removing that little snip that I heard. That's without the noise reduction. That's with the noise reduction. So that actually worked pretty well. I'll bypass it again. That's without noise reduction. And that's with it. I can turn up the reduction. Without, with. I actually like that. That did work. Yeah. I'm gonna render that. Sorry, I've not looked at comments at all. Yeah, there is something at the end there. I'm gonna edit that out when I make the loop. There's like a, yeah, like you said, it's probably a branch breaking is what it is. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I mean, these are the kind of sounds that really you only notice them when you're not going to be doing much in the game. You know, it'll be just when you're just walking or traveling. I mean, we will set it up so that these sounds get turned down or ducked as soon as combat happens, just because they'll just get in the way and kind of kills the epicness. It's like, yeah, I just slaughtered 10 of my enemies, and then crickets. That's the sound of me drinking water. It's such a good sound. Okay, I'm gonna go back to actually. That's what I started with. It's obviously a lot louder. I cut out some frequencies that the volume has dropped. Sometimes EQs can add peakiness to audio, which is what I kind of think is that weird little peak that I saw around 2000 hertz. I'm actually going to try what I just did with the full audio. I need to find that same little clip that has no crickets. I don't know how I'm going to do that, but nope. Nope. This is hard. I bet you guys are like, what the hell is he doing? That might be a good one. I can tell just because it's, there's no like really high, well, there's the high frequency buzz I don't want, but there's no like chirp sound in it. This is just kind of an experiment here, so bear with me. Happy crickets. Think happy crickets. I mean, that's really heavy on the noise reduction. It still kind of worked, though. It's just got the buzzing. It hasn't decided that the buzz is something I don't want. You can mess with the profile. The curve, this blue line, is the noise profile that it's... Or actually, no, sorry, it's the, well, it is kind of the noise. You're just telling it to ignore or pay attention to certain frequency ranges differently, so. I don't want low end. And there, like, my buzzing is gone. That's pretty good, actually. Bypass it. Happy crickets. How much can I get away with? I mean, they start sounding like they're in like a tiny box when you do that.
see how it takes away the tail. It takes away the reverb tails of things, so you kind of want a little bit of echo to it. The buzz is a lot louder now for some reason. Maybe I was just listening to a section that didn't have it. Yeah, there must be a section in there that I didn't find when I scanned earlier that doesn't actually have the buzz, so that's obviously what I'm going to look for. I think when I was scanning through before, I thought the file was only like 30 seconds, so I just kind of picked three spots and didn't realize the whole clip is 3 minutes and 10 seconds as it says up there, so. I'm just going to render that out and see where that gets me. Yeah, dog. Yeah, there's a dog in there. The file said this is from Rwanda. So, dingo? No, that's in Australia. What are the African dogs? Don't know. Yeah, I probably should have edited that track. It's taking so long because it's such a long clip. Yeah, look at that. I mean, it's funny because now you can actually see what's left. That's the part that doesn't have the buzzing. Yeah, he's there. He's there. Cool. So he's not there. All right. This is where I want then. Yeah, he shuts up right there. I wonder if that was that. Remember how earlier I was like, hey, what's that up in the high frequency? There's like some weird digital artifact going, and it's probably this bug dropping in and out here. Watch, I'll prove it. So he cuts out basically like, I don't know, a third of the way into the clip. Yeah, so he cuts out right there, but I'm gonna load this up in this other crap, it's not going to let me do that because it can only do 45 seconds at a time, I think. Anyways, crap, where was it? I'll show him turning off. So he turns off like right there. So I'm just going to do here and here and load this up. And about in the middle, you'll see that this guy shuts up. Yeah, see that? You see all this stuff right there? And that's that bug stopping. It's weird because it's so. And then that must be another one starting like off in the background or something, because it's like the same frequency range, but just not as loud. But right here is the stuff I want. That's really funny. It's crazy to look at audio files like this sometimes. You see all sorts of weird stuff like bats. You know, because you can't hear them, but this program will show them. I'm running the session at 44.1. So if I was running this session at a higher sample rate, which means you can hear and see those higher frequencies. I've seen pictures of guys that are running sessions at 96 or 192. And, yeah, you'll see all sorts of bats up in the like 30 and 40, 50,000 hertz range, which is stuff we do not hear. So, yeah, halfway through. Yeah, no buzzy guy. So let's just edit this. Let's just go before the little clip. Okay, so let's edit this guy into a loop. Hmm.
there's that higher cricket. And there he's done. He's like, brit, 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 brit. Right, he starts out in the beginning. And then he's done. And then he starts back up towards the end. Yeah, like right there. So he kind of points out the loop, actually. And, I mean, I like him, but I don't want to have to find another section that doesn't have the buzzing. So I'm going to cut him out, seeing as how this was kind of my only good section that didn't have the buzzy guy in it. So he's done there. You can kind of see him even in the waveform. See how it's like a little bit louder there? That's his last chirp right there. So I'll do that. And then I think he starts like right here. Yeah, maybe a couple. Yeah, he kind of starts on that one. So that leaves me with it's a 5-second audio loop. Not great, but I like to do probably usually about twice that, but you guys are silly. So yeah, let's make a loop out of this. Whoops, wrong button. And usually just I'll overlap this chirp onto that chirp and do a little crossfade and see where that gets us. Funny, like I can actually hear stuff in the background now that I'm fully listening to it. There's like almost sounds like a dog bark in the very, very beginning. And there's like some sort of bounce right around here or something. But this is probably gonna get played back in game. That volume, but now let me just better safe than sorry, I guess. So let's do another noise reduction pass. I know now I can clearly see what I want and don't want. Maybe I'll just cut out those first couple. And then there's this, there's something in here. There's like a bonk in the background there. So maybe I'll just cut that guy out too. And then my sanity is maintained, I guess. Probably not, but I can try. And let's see if that will edit itself together nicely without a weird. I still hear that bonk back here too. I don't know if you guys hear that or not. Am I hearing things? I am hearing things. I'm a sound designer. I hear things all the time. Okay, I'll get rid of that one. Not too keen on that, but try and keep the rhythm going. It's almost too short now. You can hear the loop. But I mean, I was almost thinking too, like, I have them so isolated now, I could just make the audio file this. There's a little bit of, like, high frequency noise in there that I'd probably want out. But I could almost make that just my cricket and then have the game, like, play it back. Let me try one more noise reduction on it. Learn, new program. And reduce. I don't even know. It's such a small clip now, you can't even tell what you're listening to. It sounds so weird to hear it like that. I probably need, I know from past experience that I need that much, at least. Because it kind of like takes like half a second for the noise reduction to kick in. I can't tell what this is doing with this thing looping like that. It's kind of hard to, just curious, I guess. I mean, that kind of would work. It's a little quiet, and what is it? So, like, I mean, I guess it'd probably be playing back in game like that. You know? Like, hey, all right, instead of a 10-second file, now we have a third of a second file. See, so the game would be like, this is too fast, but all right, you kind of hear that it's a loop, but what I could do is go in and do the same noise reduction to a few others. Same noise reduction. I'm not even going to bother listening to it. Just going to do it to those. Oh, what gain did I do? Let's just set that back to zero. Let's do the same for a few others. So I now have four cricket chirps. And like the other thing too is like I would have this, I would have another bed of audio going at the same time. There's a plugin that we're using for Wyze called Soundseeda Air. And it has like a wind synthesizer in it basically. And it works pretty well. And that'll be going. So that'll be kind of like the lowest just kind of like ambience as opposed to silence, you know? It's kind of like how in films you have room tone for things. Room tone is when like you're in a, it's an interior shot, obviously, and you're editing all the dialogue and you take out all the background noise and you're like, great, I have this clean dialogue track. And it's just dialogue. And even though there's no other action going on, like in between the dialogue, you can't have just pure silence. It sounds so weird to do that. And you don't really notice it. But all movies do this. They have like the room tone, which is just like on set, you'll be like, hey, the sound guy's got to record room tone. And he just puts his mics up. Usually in a similar position that he was recording the dialogue, and then you just roll sound for like, you know, a minute or two. And then the editor, the sound editor, can lay that in underneath the dialogue. And that way you won't just have just pure silence in between dialogue, because that can be a little like weird. So there's four little cricket chirps, and I could edit these like that so that the start of the cricket chirp is at the beginning of the file. This must be like, yeah, there's a little like guy there. I don't know what's going on at the beginning of this one. Yeah. I mean, he's just, that's just part of his flutter. So now, I have this. Let's see here. Let me do a grid here so I can evenly space them. since these guys are metronomes, I'm sure. And let's just duplicate it for a few seconds. And it's like, hey. We have crickets. Now it'd be randomized. You can kind of hear. Let's go ahead and do that. I'll do that same noise reduction before I close this plugin and lose my settings like an idiot. I'll do some more of them, but now we have crickets, and then I can do things like, I don't know, have the frequency, not the audio frequency, but like the how often they chirp, like speed up and slow down based on altitude in the game or seasons or maybe temperature, and then it'll be completely scientifically accurate and I'll be able to die a happy man, I guess. So let's do that. Get off grid. Let's do that for a few of these other guys. Like I said, before I lose these settings, that one's got that junk in the front that I don't want. That one kind of does too. I don't know what that is. It's like another cricket. It's funny. I'm basically cutting all of the individual crickets from that one cricket file into just their little solo performances now. So render that. Render that. Render that. Yeah, so I need to edit those a little bit. Those are the four edited ones. Yeah, that one's got this little guy trying to get in on this other dude's solo performance. A little hiccup in that one, but that's cool because crickets aren't perfect. They're happy crickets. Some other dude trying to jump in on his solo performance. How cool. Isn't that cool? Happy crickets. Okay. See how much time you can spend just on crickets? So now that I have these guys, let's go back to where I was before, which is going to be a little loud. That. Dogs, rumble, annoying high frequency, crickets. Sound like someone left their bug zapper on, or someone just like got their hand on their bug zapper, just holding on to it, zapping themselves. And now we just have happy little crickets. Obviously, I wasn't going for like the cricket chorus type thing, which should be more like, I already have one of those files. Where is it? I think it's this one. See, like that one you can't, that's got like the reverb of the forest in it, and you just gotta have a good recording to kind of do something like that. But those are distant crickets, and then, you know, maybe we'd have like little individual crickets that you would actually notice like passing by them, as opposed to it just being a static sound that just kind of moves with you, you know. These little cricket guys, like, you know, they can change and you can walk past them and they would maybe, you know, pan accordingly and things. See how I just like throw those guys underneath and then they kind of just blend in. So, you know, just, and since I haven't broken out into different layers, now that they now I can, you know, control them on their own. Did I just delete one? No, okay. So these are the guys I need to export. Let's name them Cricut. Oh, let's be smart and use my naming convention. I'm really bad at naming conventions. It's terrible. Copy that. Let's do that. And this. Maybe a Pine Forest Cricut Solo Chirp. One. Copy that. Let's bake. I'm like rendering those little fade ins and fade outs that I applied into the scene, into the little clip. And now I can do this. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Seven. Okay. There's 7 files. I will export them all out. And bam, there we go. They might actually even be mono files in game too. Like I probably don't need stereo for that. But that's a lot of additional server instructions. During battle? No, it's actually all done on the client. Basically, I just have different buses is what they're called in audio, but just think of like, they're just different categories of audio. It's like, I have combat audio, and then I have ambience audio, and the audio middleware program can look at those different groups and see that if one of them is playing or making sound that the other one should not play. So in that case, it'd be like, oh, combat stuff is happening. Let's just turn off the ambience stuff. And then the ambience would just duck away. And that's all done on the client. Talking about idea of quieting crickets when enemies are walking near them. I could still even do that on my end. Because I could make a footstep group. And then if that group is making noise, then I could turn down the ambience. So that could still even be done just on the client side. The only catch with that is that I would need to make sure that I have distinctions between your own footsteps and other people's footsteps. Maybe even specifically enemies' footsteps, but, you know, that's almost kind of a game design choice at that point, so... But yeah, those kind of things are doable. Real stealthy. Stealth games kind of do that stuff. Okay. So while we're on nighttime stuff, I just wanted to show you this. This is something that's cool. With ambience files. When you pitch stuff around, when you change the pitch and playback speed of it, you get all sorts of cool effects. So let me switch to my sound program. Okay, yeah. Is this the one I wanted to do? Yeah. So Amazon Jungle Forest, right? This is the pitch slider, and I'm going to pitch it way down. Sounds like a helicopter. Let's go up a little bit. Oh, there we go. There's one part where that annoying kind of helicopter thing quits. So that's cool.
So yeah, so maybe this would be like what you hear when the TDD like on an area at night. It'd be something like that. Let's see if I can, yeah. And you can see where that guy is. He kind of pops in and out. There's another quiet part. How low do we want to go? Oh, he keeps jumping around the slider. I think I like it about there. So let's hit S, and I think that'll, I hope that pitches it or spots it into my session at the right pitch. Yeah, it did. Okay, cool. So now we have this crazy nighttime ambience. And I'm going to make a loop out of this. Let me just do this since that's what I... Whoops, what was that? I hit copy. Bring this to the front. That's a long track. It's 10 minutes long. And I'm really going to need that part. That helicopter guy comes back in there. So that's 12 seconds of audio. I can see where he's there and not, just based on the waveform showing. He's not there. Probably starts about here. Yep. Oh, that was a weird groan. You hear that? That's weird. Don't know what that is. It's probably like a frog, but since I've pitched it down like so much, it sounds like the devil. Don't listen to your records backwards, kids. It's there too. It's weird. It's gotta be a frog. Actually, there's too much of that low groany guy actually in that part, so. Sorry for the pinging. I'll just close that so you don't have to listen to my. It's just a programmer. What does he want? Can't be that important. Okay, there, it's kind of quiet too. Well, that's a good long section. I'll probably use that. Okay, starts back up there. So that's 34 seconds. Something cut out there. Yeah, there's one of those helicopter guys off in the background that I can hear. He cuts out right there, so I'll start there. (laughs)
Those groans crack me up. They're like, I don't know if you guys can hear that or not. So I'll delete that little last bit. And that's 22 seconds. Let's see. I might EQ this a little bit because some frequencies are a little harsh. Man, I wish I had better audio suite EQ plugins. I don't really want to use that 7-band EQ. Okay, I'll just do it the harder way and bounce this to a different track. Print, audio input, print, record, solo safe. Okay, now let's do a EQ. I like this EQ a lot. Look at how many knobs it's got. Must be good, right? Okay. I kind of like cutting out the high end. There's like a lot of like just kind of nondescript noise up there. It just sounds fatiguing to me, so I'm gonna cut that out. That makes it feel a little smoother. Let's see. I think I still hear those groans. I think I do, yeah. It's funny. They're not as obvious as those other ones, but they're there. Alright, totally there, that on that part. Boy, I'm like chopping the low end out. And I swear I still hear it. Maybe I'm hearing things. It's a distinct possibility. All right, I think I'm cool with that. Here, let's bypass it. See what it's like before. It's a lot quieter. Let's make an equal volume comparison. Oh, it seems like I got 4 dB of gain. Well, that's just louder, so it's hard to compare things when they're two different volumes, but no EQ with the EQ. It's hard to make equal volume comparison, so that's not going to happen here. I think I like that. It sounds just like less irritating on the ears. You know, and that just means quieter, so that's part of it, but I think the frequencies are just better for ambience, you know? You don't really need full spectrum, you just kind of need what's there to get the point across. So, now that you're, going insane from listening to weird cricket sounds, I'm gonna have to do it again because I gotta print this. Since I'm bouncing it down to a separate track, I have to, it only does it in real time. I'll check on some comments. I like how you guys are debating, like, the craziness of the realms. This won't be for all forests. This will just be maybe for, like, when the TDD own a forest. This will get played to kind of tell you, like, ooh, I am in that particular realm's territory. So let's make a loop. Loop-de-doop. I like that little beep-beep. Okay. He's cool. Do I want to leave the beep beep guy in? I think I might take him out. Oh, wait. I'm not soloing a track. I was hearing crickets from this other thing. I was like, why is that so loud? I was like, yeah, that's what it sounded like. I was like, I don't remember all this other, these other crickets that actually sound at the correct pitch. Okay, let's make a loop. This one's fairly nondescript, so I'm not too worried about it causing any issues. Huh, you can kind of hear that. Something changes in the ambience right there at the beginning of that. This is the weird part of my job that I don't know how to describe. Because I'm like listening for these. Oh, hold on a second. Hey. Okay. So, yeah, I think this last part of it works better. You still kind of hear it. There's like subtle perspective shift. That might just be solved with a longer crossfade, actually. Yeah. So let's see what this does. I can hear the loop a little bit. This, since there's those little beepy guys in there, there's guys that go boop, boop. Yeah, there's one right there. He goes, hop. They kind of give away some of the loop. So this might be a case where I'll export these, or I'll import these rather, into the audio middleware program as like four chunks, and then it'll randomize these and like crossfade them in the game. Because otherwise, you'll just hear this beep guy every, you know, 13 seconds or whatever the length of it was. And this way, if I'm randomizing these, you'll still hear him. Periodically, it just won't be every 13 seconds or whatever it was. Okay. I'll do that.
Ambient. This is now TDD.
I guess this only works obviously in a TDD owned forest. So if the TDD owns, say, a swamp, this might not really work. Maybe it could. But like if it's like a snowy, desolate area, then have to do something else. In fact, probably do owls or something like that. Let's see, TDD, night time, chorus, because it's kind of a cricket chorus. And why don't I have underscores under these? Did I do that? Oh. Is that how I was naming the other ones that didn't have underscores? That's weird. I almost always do that. Weird. Okay. Sorry. TDD, night, time, chorus, part, because it's part. I have to play all four of these. Part one. I'm not worried about looping points because the game will kind of make it loop for me. I can string these four things together. And it'll crossfade them for me so there aren't pops. Let's get those out of here. And bam. I have some TDD owned stuff. That's what I made. This is what it sounded like originally. Oh wait, that's a pitch. That's what it sounded like. Cool. Let's delete this track. I don't need that track. Don't need it. I need to make some crows. I know I need some individual crow chirps. So I have a file that I want to use for those. And I can also, while I'm at it, show you another crazy thing that can be done by changing the pitch of audio. I have this sound library of like really close up crows. Like weird animals. I mean, how hilarious is that? But so this was recorded at 192,000 samples per second. So a very, very high sample rate, which means that you can pitch it down and it still sounds decent. If you don't record at those high sample rates, basically when you pitch things down, they lose a lot of their like high end detail and it just sounds dull and like muffled. But check this out. So that's that crow that we were just listening to pitched way down. That is a crow. It is a crow. I mean, it sounds like he's talking. And then. Anyways, birds are good for that kind of stuff if you have these like really isolated recordings of them. So like I'll probably use those for, I don't know, one of the weirder races, one of the more primal races, because you know I'll need to make like battle grunts and you know just kind of vocalizations of combat and stuff like that, and I'll probably use stuff like that. So even if you don't get to see me make them via a Twitch stream, you'll know how they were made. So this is the... Yeah, I don't... I wish I had more crows like this. I think... I thought I downloaded more... What is this? No, that's got too much junk in it. Oh, there, that's another good one. Oh, sorry, that's probably loud. That's a pretty good one. Yeah, so all those I'm going to create little crow loops. Not loops, just individual stuff. And those can be part of the indicators for the Vikings, maybe. So, I guess that means I can only play crows when the Vikings own a piece of territory, which is fine. That'll be a good little... It's a pretty obvious tell. I like those dissonant ones too, actually. And this one. And let's see if I have any others. Don't think so. Oh, that's crowd. Searched for crow and it brought up crowd. Spelling. Words. I don't need words. I'm a sound guy. I need words. I'm not gonna lie. Let's do that. Let's do... those two. We'll do that one. A lot. Maybe just do five. They've got like 3, 3, 2, and 5. It's kind of cut off there. Hey, they didn't give me my tail. They didn't give me my reverb tail. I paid for that sound, damn it. Like here. That one fully rings out. I don't know if you noticed that, but the tail gets cut short. Look, let me zoom in all the way. See? It sounds like he's in a room, kind of. It sounds, makes it sound like he's in a small room. Right? As opposed to, like, this one? Just got a little more tail to it. Yeah. Subtle things you notice when you're a sound designer. So yeah, I don't want that. Get out of here. I'll just use these two. I think that one's fine. Get up close to the next one. And let's do these. Those are good. So like maybe we can set it up so that when the state of the territory changes, it's like maybe real obvious. So you hear these like, these guys, you know, they're... pretty loud and up front. And then maybe like, you know, after that territory's been owned for a minute or two, you're not hearing these guys, you're like, okay, I get it. I hear the crows, all right, enough. And then maybe these guys will come in. You know.
Those are pretty clean too. There's a little bit of junk in the background. I hear little bird tweets. Oh, no, I don't. Do I? Oh, yeah, they're right in the beginning. And they're over this guy's first call here. I don't think I'm going to worry about that. So we got... The question is, do I want to do anything more to these? Like, I'll wait for later, but maybe an idea would be to, like, throw on some more reverb for one of them so that, you could have stuff that sounded like it was at a castle. That's not a castle, but... you know, versus... You could make the sound fit in different environments. Castle would sound more like... Something like that, maybe. A little more pre-delay. Yeah, you know, you can futz around with that. I don't think I'm gonna do that right now, though. You want nightmare sounds to listen to while you're working. That's funny. Yeah, YouTube, I'm sure. There's so many, like, 10 hours of waterfall. 10 hours of beach sounds. Oh, let's turn off my reverb. This is a nice one. A little conversation there. Of some distant crows. Almost too distant, those guys. Yeah. Yeah, okay, so... Okay. Man, I'm cutting off my tails. Look at that. Look at that. I mean, clearly, it's supposed to ring out longer. It's just like, nope, you don't get that. It's all right. Still good. Recording. Okay. Do I need this, like, conversation? That's probably pretty noticeable. You'll remember that one. Sometimes, you know, background sounds are supposed to be as nondescript as possible, because if you make it have too much character, then you notice it every time. Even this one. I'll put that in.
and you guys can just hate me every time you hear it, because you might notice it, because it's kind of distinct. Because he goes, rah, 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 rah. See? I showed it to you. You can never unhear it. We're not making happy crows right now. Screw Bob Ross. Making angry crows. I'm worried about losing my tails on those. I think it'll be okay because this obviously won't be the only sound playing, and really shorter files is always better for memory usage and things of the like. So I'm just kind of chopping these up right now. Making sure they're edited. I think I already did those. I didn't just do these first four. Man, those tails are, I think, well, they are kind of chopped off anyways, because, like, I'm cutting him off before his next little caw comes in. So that's partially my own fault, but that one still sounds cut off to me. Thank God. People. Jeez. Okay. So I'm going to add a little bit of reverb to these just to kind of cover that up. It'll help smooth it out a little bit. Okay. And let's just, I'll do it the easy way this time. Make that my new file, make that my new file, make that my new file, make that my new file. And let's audio suite, delay maybe? Let's see how much I can get out of that. So I'm changing the time of the delay on the left and right side, and I'm going to low pass it a little bit, and I'm going to set each side. Let's just see if that. Yeah, so. So I'm just going to do this subtly. This is going to be a two-step process. I'm just adding a little bit of delay in there. And then I'm going to add reverb after the delay. But I'm baking it in, so that's why I'm doing it in a one pass here, and then it'll be another pass later. Okay, let's just do that. That's probably fine. Okay. Just giving a little space to our angry crows. Oh my God, angry birds. Uh-oh, copyright infringement, don't sue me. Shit. Oh no, abort the broadcast. I have said something bad. We're making angry crows, you hear me? Specifically angry crows, and there are no pigs involved. All right, deverb. It's the reverb that comes in, or that comes with Pro Tools, and people love to hate on it. I don't actually hate on it that much. I find it pretty usable most of the time. Except collapsing it down to mono when I preview, that's annoying. I wish I could hear this in. Maybe I am hating on it right now. I don't like any of this. That's okay. Okay, you will go insane if you listen to the same file over and over again. Just fair warning, so kids, don't do that. I'm gonna make sure I have enough tail here. And let's render that out. Yeah. Do the same for this guy. And do the same for that guy. And we will render. Render. And render. Yeah, sounds good. Let's name these. Let's see how much time. Oh, I got 15 minutes. Okay. Let's name these. Ambient. Viking. Crow. Which version is this? This is like the up front. Let's just call it near version. One, copy that. Two, three, four. These are all the distant ones. So let's bake these in there. It's nice when you have recordings that you don't really have to mess with. I mean, I suppose I could be picky and be like, oh, I have to touch it in some way and EQ it or something, but I'm just going to leave these as is. I mean, I'm editing them a little bit, but not really processing them, so. But that's okay. I don't really feel the need to. I don't have an ego about that kind of thing. Distant version. One, two, three, four, five, six, and seven. Let's export all of those. Okay. Oh. Did I name them? I guess I named two of them three. Yeah, I did. It protested and said, hey, you're about to make two of the same file. Oh, I'm still doing that? Okay, stop. Oh, can't I just tell it to cancel? Probably because I think it exports them anyways. Let me just see here. Near version 4, yeah, 1, 2, 3, and then 7 of those, so yeah. So those are all exported. Okay. Got some crows. That's what time it is. Okay. I'm just checking chat, see if you guys have anything. Oh, that's cool. Other animals listen to the crows to alert them of danger. Yeah, I've heard of that happening, like in Africa too. Like, what are those little meerkat guys or something? I think they're like the alarm for everyone else. Cool. Okay. Let's just see if I can find an owl. I think I downloaded some owls earlier because that would be part of the TDD stuff too. Yeah, let's just see if I have any owls because that'll be something I can do in fairly quickly. Oh, was that my program just crashing? Yes, it was. Let's try that again. Ow. Okay. Ambient dogs. Why does it say owl? Oh, howling. That's why owl came up. Yeah, that's pretty good. I might try and process that a little more, but I want more of a who, the ooh ooh owls. I mean, that's kind of one, but he's real short. I could just pitch him down. Let's see what else I got. Can I exclude some things from this search results? Yes, I can. I don't want growls or howls. I just want owls. And I don't want bowls. All right, I don't know if that. Yeah, it did filter out some of the stuff. Yeah, this is that same library of all those, like, really close recordings, which is probably not what I want. Pretty gnarly. Hoot. I think I already have that sound in the game, actually. We do have some owls already. So I'm not going to put that one in. Yeah, we've already got those. Oh, that's a mono file. All right, fine. So let's do this real quick. I don't got much time left. I'm just gonna. So I want to add delay and reverb again. So I don't need a lot of delay. This is the left side, this is the right side. That's why there's like two of the same sets of controls. Let's do usually like 140 or something is a nice. Thing to start with. Do a little feedback. Okay, and let's add reverb. I'm going to use this guy because I like this one better. That might be what I want. Yeah, that works pretty well. Thank you, presets. Sometimes presets are nice. So I don't need a lot here. Let's just pick out a few from this guy. So I'll do that one. Let's do one little hoot. Hootenanny. Is this the same file? Huh. That's funny. So someone... this looks like the same thing. They're just looping it. I mean, am I right? Look. It goes... And then it goes... Those three things are repeating. They're like, yeah, we've got, you know, 20 seconds of owl hoots for you. It's like, nope. You really only have 5 seconds. You just copy and pasted it a few times. I mean, look, I can kind of prove it by doing this. Doing some little audio detective work here, and we will see that the waveforms are exactly the same. Like, yeah, I'm sure all of his hoots sound very similar, but, I mean, there's just no way. Well, oh well. Guess that's how it goes. So technically, there's only three hoots here anyways. That one. That one. And that one. So... I need to make sure... I'm going to do this slightly differently. So I'm trying to account for the tail. That's probably long enough. Let's bounce these out into ambient TDD owl hoots. One. So we'll do one there. And don't need to be that long. Let's do that one. Do two. And we'll do three. I'm just watching this meter down here to make sure I'm not cutting off my own reverb tail while I export it, because this region that I select is determining what section of audio it's bouncing out. Yeah, so that's fine. Doesn't have to be perfect. Cool. So now I got a few more owl hoots. Wasn't that a hoot? Huh? It's a hoot making hoots. I wonder if I can... I won't do that. Is there not an easy way to just copy settings from one plugin to the other? You have to make a whole preset just to do that? That's dumb. I was going to noise reduction these a little bit. Is that the same thing? It is. It's another one of the same things, right? Look. Little, big, bigger, biggest. Little, big, bigger, biggest. Boo, 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 boo. The pattern repeats. Oh, well. Huh, maybe it's not. That actually has some weird noise there. That's weird. I think it's 8 or something. Because this looks different than this guy. I mean, they're definitely different. But is this part the same? It's hard to tell. I have to throw it onto another track below me. Maybe that owl is just very regular. I don't know about that. It sounds too perfect. Well, okay. I was going to do noise reduction, but let's see. Okay, yeah. We got another stream coming up. So thanks, guys. I'm done for the day streaming. Thank you for watching. Birds are good at tempo. Yes, they are. Thanks, guys. There's more coming up next. See y'all later.